okay, that's weird. Why is this the best way to print this model? Let's find out. If you've been following me on Instagram or maybe some of the other YouTube videos, I'm printing one of my race car projects out. This is a 1/10 scale model of an SL-C, and we're printing the canopy or the greenhouse along with the doors. Combining all of these parts allowed me to experiment and test with cut lines and the part lines between the window or the glass and the fiberglass shell. Now, I played with the orientation quite a bit, and I was trying to get the print time down. The estimate on Simplified 3D, I think, went from 17, 18 hours down to under 12. It was like 11 hours, 40 minutes. It's way off, but at least gives you an idea of how much time I was able to save by orienting this part in this way. Now, the secret to this is the inside, really. I manually gave this thickness. I've been wanting to do a lot of things manually so I can go through the process to learn not only moto at a higher level, but also just learn some techniques to make this process a lot faster. I learned quite a bit by the angles and by having specific angles or more, I guess, vertical angles on the interior. I was able to print this whole part with no support structure in this area. And it's not tipped back enough that I would need any sort of support structure on the exterior, the A side of the surface. You'll notice that it's only supported along the bottom. So I've added a raft with a base layer and a top layer. And I believe I offset the supports a little bit to make them a little larger so that we get as much adhesion to the build plate as possible. Having this vertical, I did not want this to start moving when it was printing up here. Another side note about printing in this orientation is all of the print lines are going, well, in this case, I guess, horizontal, but when it's laying flat, it'll be vertical. And what that does is it gives me absolutely the best quality surface. Let's flip this around. The best quality surface all through all of these parts and only getting top layer type of patterns along the cut lines, which will be hidden from the other part, the adjacent part. This portion here, you can see a lot of ringing, and that's gonna be completely hidden by the front clip. I also got really nice print lines for this opening, it didn't look like I was going to get that if I was printing horizontally. Now, printing horizontally, that means the entire interior cavity or a big portion of it would have to have support material in order to print this hollow cavity. So we did not want that. And by placing it just on this tip, printing it here, I tipped it at, I believe, 105 degree angle, which gave me the best balance for not having it cantilevered too much and not going completely vertical where this area would need to be supported. So all of the print lines have something to print underneath, no severe overhangs. I made sure things like this had angles. Even the screw holes, the supports for the screw holes, I gave those a nice angle so that those would be able to print without bridging and without getting any strangeness on the top surface. But overall, this print came out really nice. There's a couple boogers, you know, little zits where the interior support structure and my printer, they just doesn't work out. I have the large CR10, the 500 millimeter version, and it does need some stabilization as well as it might need to be placed onto a mat so that it absorbs the shaking. Because we are getting ringing in these areas around the cut lines and some of these square edges. You know, you get that little extra material along the edge, which makes it kind of look like a tube shape, which we're trying to avoid. So I'll make a few more adjustments on the printer, but overall for what this is, pre-visualizing this car body before we go full size is perfect. I'm printing this in a silver PLA. It's a silk silver, I believe. I love the color. I've been experimenting with a lot of grays and silvers, trying to get that industrial design type of appearance model. Silver reads really well because you have a strong highlight. You still get some core shadows, but it generally reads very well. And I think this one is, so far, the best one that I'm using. The material strength seems like it's a little fragile, a little bit more than some of the other materials, but for what I'm using it for, it's amazing. Check in the description below, because if you're looking for a silver to print your models in, this one, so far, is the best. So subscribe, hit that like button, leave some comments. If you have any ideas of how to make this even better, please leave feedback. I absolutely want your participation and your feedback.